What's up, y'all? Welcome back to my channel. Happy Vlogmas Day 18. I think definitely today's Vlogmas Day 18. And as you guys can see from the title, today we are diving into apartment and moving out tips. Today I want to show you my tips that I use to build my credit from basically no credit to being able to get approved for my apartment and constantly building my credit score higher. So if that seemed like that would interest you, definitely stay tuned to the end of the video. I'll share with you guys my little tips that made my credit score go up super fast and what also helped me maintain that credit to buy a new car and buy my new apartment. So let's hop right into this. If you don't have credit, we already know credit is dumb important. Like, you honestly cannot get anything that's important without credit. And I'm saying, like, apartment wise, I did not know anything about credit when I was trying to move out at 19. I didn't have any type of credit card. I didn't even know how to start. So I had no idea about it, but I knew exactly what I needed to do to go ahead and get started with it. So first off, number one, what you need to do is get you a credit card, sis. That's the easiest thing to do. Grab you a credit card. These companies are desperate to get people in debt. So get you a credit card. My number one recommended credit card company is Capital One. Okay, Capital One is where it's at with the credit cards. So I got Capital One for the first time, and I think they send you like $300 on the card, and that is just the first way to start spending money on it and to get your credit kind of moving. So you get the card and you want to spend money on it, but don't spend everything on the credit card. You need the credit card so you can start building the credit. What I did was, when I got my Capital One card, my credit score was at 550, and I wanted to do anything to bring it up so I could actually have a average credit score, because at that point it was below average when you first start getting credit. So what I started doing was I started purchasing a lot of stuff with my credit card. For example, if I went into the store to buy a juice, swipe my credit card, go to my car and literally pay for it, pay the credit card off as soon as I got into the car, or the next day or later on that night. That is definitely my number one tip, is to swipe it and pay it right back, because they notice that stuff. They pay attention to how soon you pay the money back and also how much money you have on your balance. So if you got zero and you just paying your money back instantly, that's a proven tip that your credit is going to go up each credit report, and I definitely had results. That's T right there. Get the credit card, swipe it every chance you get, but pay it back as soon as you are finished or the next day. Just pay it back before the due date. That's overall the key. Pay it back before the due date. Definitely do 2 payments a month. And like I just said, you can do it as soon as you leave the store, which of course is more than 2 payments a month. But if not, you can do 2 payments a month. I usually like to do 1 on the 1st, and I started doing 1 on the 15th, because I know that I got like credit score reports around like the 5th and also like the 30th. So I wanted to pay it before the due date so I could see my credit score change both times throughout the month. So definitely make 2 payments a month. I feel like it definitely helps when you know what days your credit card, you know, increases or decreases your score, because they do it multiple times a month. Check out what days they give you updates on your credit report. I know mine was like the 5th and the 30th, so I decided on the 1st and the 15th, I'm gonna make a payment so that each time I see my credit score is going up, and I know that I'm paying my payments one time away before the due date, so I know it's gonna go up. So that's definitely my key, you know. It don't have to be $100. You can make 2 $30 payments, 1 on the 1st, 1 on the 15th, or whatever your balance is. Just do that. I know people say once a month, but 2 times a month, it's gonna move it fast. My next tip for building your credit and getting it up there fast is to have some control, okay? You're gonna have a credit card, and once you get that $300, they're gonna try and increase it to $500, then to $1,000, then to $1,500, then to, baby, you need to know when to not spend too much on that card. Don't overspend. Don't spend more than they've given you. If they've given you $300, try and spend less than 3%, not 3%, try to spend less than 30% of the card balance. they send you $300, try and stay under 150 or 100. Like, don't go too crazy with it, because that also affects your credit score. If you spend everything on the card, it makes your credit score go even down, and we're not trying to do that because we're trying to move out. So, you know, keep it under control. They will definitely try and get you with these credit card companies, because baby girl, they just increased my limit to, I think, like $1,500, and I'm like, y'all are not about to do this to me. I am not about to lose my control. So definitely keep your control. Don't spend too much on the credit card. Do not use it as your only source of income. Use it specifically to build your credit, okay? So that's definitely my tips. And when I tell you that these tips definitely helped me move my credit score up, because I didn't have no credit score when I moved out. I had 550, and not having credit can definitely affect a lot when it comes to applying for your apartment, because me and my best friend were super duper young and we didn't have any credit. We were 19 and 18, and we were like, yeah, we're trying to move out, but they're like, hey, what's your credit score? Like, y'all have credit? And we didn't have any. So both of us got a credit card around the same time of trying to apply, and within probably a month we were able to get our apartment. Now, our credit didn't move up too much, but it did move up a little bit with us, you know, using our credit card and trying to make our score go up. It just went up a little bit to 600 something. So that definitely shows that these tips help you get some action in your credit score within a couple of weeks. So yeah, that's what happened with my first apartment. They were super lenient with it. So to kind of give an outlook on an apartment that is a lot more maybe harder and strict with the credit scores, and it may be like a luxury apartment like mine, I felt like they would have definitely turned me away if I walked in with a 550 credit score. So by that point of my second apartment, I had already been following these tips, making my two payments of $30 a month and using my credit card on a regular and paying it off quickly. I did that, and by the time it was time to move out again the second time, my credit score had went all the way up to like a 694. So I had no worries about getting approved for this apartment credit wise because I did apply for the apartment during unemployment time. So that was the only reason I thought they would approve me. But credit wise, baby girl, I was straight like Jake, okay? My credit was looking beautiful. So it's a proven fact, this really freaking works. And even when there's times where you may overspend on your credit, you may spend a little bit too much on your credit card once you get it, it may be a bad week for you, but like I said, to make it go right back up, you need to follow these tips to the T. Be consistent with your payments. Don't spend too much. Pay immediately. If you don't have credit, it can definitely affect the price of your deposit for the apartment. Deposits can either be $500 or be two times their rent with no credit. Like, that depends on everything, because they want to know that you're going to pay the money back, that you're a reliable person, that they can trust you. And that credit is to prove it, you know? The credit card is to prove this person is somebody we can trust. This person is responsible. They pay their dues and they deserve this place. So if not, they'll try and charge you double, triple the rent, and that's just absurd, right? And some of them can even just, you know, decline you or disapprove your application just because you don't have credit and they think you're just not trustworthy. So definitely get your credit. Some apartments definitely require higher credit scores, or some apartments are a lot more strict with the credit. It definitely depends on what type of apartment you're getting. You guys saw my first apartment and what it looks like. You can go check that out right here. It was definitely in a regular area, probably in a low income area, so they were probably very lenient and able to work with people. So probably if you're in a super luxury apartment or a super duper nice high income area, they may be a little bit more stricter on the credit. So just definitely consider these tips. If you need a little bit more time to get your credit score up, then do that, girl. Don't be scared, don't be shy. We are going to bring back these apartment videos on my channel. I get comments every day about you guys wanting to move along with your process, and I feel like I have not been giving you guys what you want lately. I feel like I've been posting videos that are maybe just all over the place and not in my niche, and I know my niche is moving out, lifestyle, and apartments. Y'all like to see me touring apartments. Y'all love to see me giving tips on how to move out and be successful and accomplish these big goals, like getting an apartment, getting a car, and I'm gonna try and stick to that. So I'm super excited about this channel rebrand. Drop a comment of the next topic you want to see me talk about in regards to moving out. And yeah, thank you guys so much for watching this video. This was just some super quick tips, probably like 5 tips that definitely helped me get my credit score up. Yeah, thank you guys so much for watching. I hope this video was a huge help to you guys, and I'll see you beautifuls in my next video. Bye beautifuls.